Good afternoon. Welcome on this solemnity of the most holy body and blood of Christ. A few announcements before we begin. Thank you for remembering to bring your non-perishable food items for the UH Food Walk. This is our tangible monthly donation for the UH Food Walk and in our way of helping our community, especially those in need, the students who need additional supplements. So thank you so much for your generosity. Second, we would like to give a Newman welcome to our newest staff member here at the Newman Center. He is Brandon Akiona. Welcome. Who is our communications and pastoral associate, assistant. And he is going to help us update all our website, our social media, which we haven't been updating for a while now. And so now we have a dedicated person to help us with that. And also to help me in the pastoral aspects of my ministry, training of new volunteers, of ministers, offering workshops for the parish. So we welcome Brandon Akiona to Newman Center. And finally, this coming Friday is a holiday. It's the King Kamehameha Day. And so in observance of that holiday, the Newman Center will be closed. We will still have the 12:10 p.m. Mass on that day. And we will open right before Mass and close right after. Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Our Lord was challenged in the desert to change stones into bread, but instead became bread himself. And so to prepare ourselves for these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. Lord Jesus, you are the bread of life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the cup of blessing. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the true vine. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
In accordance with all these words of his. The
Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, Jesus' disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?" He sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city, and a man will meet you, carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room, where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there." The disciples then went off, entered the city, and found it just as he told them, and they prepared the Passover. While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, gave it to them, and said, "Take it. This is my body." Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." Then, after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of the Lord. Today, the Church celebrates the solemnity of the most holy body and blood of Christ. Some of my most memorable moments of my ministry has been around this feast of Corpus Christi. The first was when I was ordained a transitional deacon, and my very first homily was on this feast day. But it was very nerve-wracking, because it was the bishop who was the celebrant of the Mass. But I found comfort in processing the Blessed Sacrament through the streets of Honolulu. The second memory was two summers ago, when Father EJ and I walked through the Camino de Santiago in Spain. After walking 72 miles across of Spain, we so happened to arrive in Santiago de Compostela on the weekend of Corpus Christi. How fitting, huh? And we got the privilege of joining their procession through the city, from the Church of St. Francis to the cathedral. But for me, the most moving moment was at the final benediction. Here, we were in the busy square where people were having lunch, were shopping, were walking around, doing those tourist things, and all of a sudden, it became quiet. It became silent, and all attention was on the monstrance containing the body of Christ. And for me, that was quite profound. Today's solemnity reminds us and celebrates this great mystery, where simple bread and wine, work of human hands, become truly the body and blood, soul and divinity of the risen Lord Jesus Christ. And we are reminded that the Eucharistic species is not just a symbolic representation of Christ, but it is his very body and blood. Neither is it a little piece of his flesh or a little sip of his blood, but it is the whole Christ, whole and entire. Notice that all of today's readings are in the context of the Passover. The
The first reading recalls the Old Covenant celebrated at Mount Sinai following the first Passover and the Exodus. In sprinkling the blood of the covenant on the Israelites, Moses was symbolizing God's desire in this covenant to make them his family, his blood relatives. Moses tells the people, "This is the blood of the covenant that the Lord has made with you." Then in today's gospel, we see Jesus elevating and transforming this covenant symbol to an extraordinary reality. In the new covenant made in the blood of Christ, we truly become one with his body and blood. You see, the first covenant made with Moses and Israel at Sinai was but a shadow of this new and greater covenant made by Christ with all humankind in that upper room. The Passover that Jesus celebrates with his 12 apostles actualizes what could only be symbolized by Moses' sacrifice at the altar with 12 pillars. What Jesus does in the gospel is establish his church as the new Israel. And this Eucharist as the new worship of the living God. So this means no more offering holocausts and sacrifices of young bulls or any animals as peace offerings. And thanks be to God, because you don't have to bring your chickens and your goats over here, then I don't have to sacrifice them, right? You see, at the Jewish Passover, the entire liturgy revolved around the body and blood of the sacrificial Passover lamb. Yet at the Last Supper, Jesus did something entirely different. He shifted the focus away from the body and blood of the lamb, and he turned it towards his own body and blood. And that was the new Passover celebration, once and for all. And that this Eucharist that we celebrate Sunday after Sunday makes it present. So the Eucharist reveals to us God's great plan of love for the world. In the old Passover, Passover was completed by eating the lamb. You have to eat the lamb. But in this new Passover, the main difference is that the lamb is a person, and the person of Jesus Christ. And the blood of the redemption is the blood of Christ. You see, God wants to feed us, and he wants to feed us in this supernatural way. Why? Because he wants to live in each one of us. He wants his body and his blood to nourish and sustain us. I'm pretty sure you have heard the saying, "You are what you eat." Huh? Did you know that it was actually a saint who said that? Saint Augustine, who said, "You are what you eat." Meaning, as we eat and drink the body and blood of Christ, the more we become like Christ. My dear friends, this solemnity is about living and growing as church through the Eucharist. And that is why we gather here Sunday after Sunday. He takes all that we offer, the little that we have, offers it to the Father, and the Father returns it back to us as his Son's very being. And because we become more like Christ, we then have a greater responsibility in the world. At the end of every Mass, we are sent out. And when we are sent out, we are to transform the world as the body of Christ. We are called to transform it by our lives. And when we do that, we imitate God and feed the people around us, both physically and spiritually, especially those who are poor, lonely, sick, and disenfranchised. And I think that is the challenge for each of us this day, that how am I doing just that? Being the body of Christ to the world. And may we then, if we have been transformed by this Eucharist, really go out and respond to the Lord's invitation to be the food that this world desperately needs. Let us respond to his invitation, approaching this altar, calling upon his name in thanksgiving, and taking up the cup of salvation to the world. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our Savior was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. We offer our prayers and petitions to our loving God.
That in our prayer and work together, our human community may be faithful to our new covenant with God, sealed in the body and blood of Christ Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all nations and God's word of justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the body and blood of Christ, shed for all humanity, be the source of unity and reconciliation among all who claim the name of Christian. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace and unity we experience at this table may be translated into works of compassion and mercy for the poor and suffering members. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our student community, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our benefactors, friends, and supporters, that God will reward them for their kindness to us and continue to bless our ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers on our website and for those who now mention.
For the intentions, for healing, for Susan and Claude Phillips, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious Father, giver and nurturer of all life, hear our prayers. May the bread and wine of the Eucharist make us bread for one another and for all, that we might become ministers of your life and love to our hurting world. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the bread of life and our Lord. Amen. Amen. pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant our church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery, in the offerings we here present, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John Henry Newman, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant Francis, our Pope, and Larry, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Let us offer each other this sign of peace. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. can share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by a reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you for joining us on this solemnity of the most holy body and blood of Christ. There's no changes to our directives currently. We're still wearing masks indoors, sanitizing our hands, still no congregational singing per our government's orders. So hopefully the next few weeks that will be lifted, but please be aware of any changes through flock notes, and also to be vigilant of all these directives, and thank you for complying with them. And also, this coming 3 weeks, I will be away. I will be going for my residency for my doctoral program in Oregon. And so there will be visiting priests. So please be nice. Don't bite. Okay? And so they will be covering what I've got. And my staff members will be here to help you if you need anything. I told them, do not call me unless the building's on fire. But please pray for me as I go back to school. It's been a couple of years since I went back to school, so pray for me and as I pray for you. Very intensive 3 weeks, and then followed by the coursework till December. So pray for me. And we'll see you back in July. Please stay well and be blessed, and we'll see you then. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
And thanks be to God.